Okay, little crash course marketing here from tweet to lead. It's all about sales funnels. And really what I'm going to show you is a very fast crash course how to know all the secrets about marketing, because really when you know these seven steps of sales psychology, from feeder to thank you and tell a friend, you got all the magic that you need. It is literally the secret behind every successful company, behind every successful relationship, behind every successful human being. So once you know this seven-step sales psychology, you also know how to deal with life, and you can literally figure out where you are and what to improve and what to do less of. So sales psychology is all about bringing people from attention to commitment. And I'll take the camera off and I'm going to give you a little fly-through presentation. I hope this works. This is all experimenting. I'm doing my best as well, so hold on a sec. So first of all, the seven-step sales psychology are these seven things. What you see here is feeder, number one. Feeder, number two, squeeze pages, number three, landing, sales, upsell, merchant, and thank you. Now, how does that work? Where do we start? First of all, there's nothing. I hope you agree. There's absolutely nothing. And from nothing, you start doing feeders, or also another word is teasers. And teasers are all kinds of messages, pictures, videos of, for example, wonderful girls, palm trees, smiley faces, houses, boats, cars, aeroplanes, good written materials or articles, and press releases could be a feeder as well. But a feeder is based on four basic instincts, and the four basic instincts is, first of all, sexual and personal relationships. Second of all, ambition, people want to be something or belong to somewhere. The third is self-awareness, very important basic instinct. And the fourth one is security, that has to do with food, clothes and shelter. So the feeders that you make are all based on triggering people's attention in those four basic instinct areas. So feeders are made of really wonderful pictures and wonderful videos and music and anything to do with your senses and with your four basic instincts. From feeders you go to squeeze pages. Now, what is a squeeze page? You always land up on some sort of a page that looks similar to this. Number two, squeeze page. A squeeze page's only purpose is to get people from feeders to leaving their email address. This is an opt-in email address area. And in the video on your squeeze page, you could say, okay, wonderful, you landed now on my squeeze page, and how about the fact, or how about telling you the next big secret of surfboards in the next free video? Leave your email and I'll definitely give you the number one secret of becoming a world-class surfer. In the next video, I'll give you the secret of how to lose 30 pounds in 3 days. You know, so in the squeeze page area, you literally portray a good life in the next step, or you say that you will reveal the big secret of whatever they're interested in the next video on the next page. All to do with having them leave their email address. That's all you're after on the squeeze page. And the squeeze page, you could also reveal something here, you know, and say, look, if you, for example, the big secret about selling things online is have a proper sales funnel. That could be the first secret that you reveal on a squeeze page, and you say, well, there's more to it. There's really six more steps to it, and in the next video I'll show you the next six steps so that you can be a huge marketer yourself. That's the squeeze page. Once the squeeze page is done and they filled out their email, you go into the landing page area. Landing page area is that long drawn out page with everything about the product or service. That's really the big information page. On a good landing page, you can read and see what it is, why they should buy it from you, how they can get it, how much it costs, the 100% not good money back guarantee, the terms, the conditions, pictures of the actual goods and services. So the sales, the landing page area is really the information area. Page. It's really the information area where also a lot of testimonials are on. As much testimonials, the better. So a good landing page is literally informs your client, your affiliate, your member with all the information they need to know. Then the fourth area, and from that they make a decision. And don't forget, people need to see, smell, hear, or touch something 12 to 15 times before they make up their mind. So don't think you'll get rid of a one-shot sales page. From the sales page, they make up their mind and they go to, before they purchase, so between the sales and the merchant account, between the sales and the merchant account where they pay, they go to an up or down sell ladder area. And their up or down sell ladder area, oh, excuse me, from the landing page, here goes my theory, from the landing pages, they go to a one-time offer page. This is still in Dutch, I did this in Dutch as well. Just a minute ago. So the landing pages go over to a sales page, and the sales page has OTO on it for your information. Not that you say OTO on the actual page, but OTO stands for one time offer. On the actual sales page, after they've gone through all the information, you make a one time offer on your sales page and you say, okay, you've seen all the information, you see all this price structures. This week we're offering it for you instead of 97 for 57, or instead of for 57 for 27. But that's only this week. So there's scarcity marketing on here. There's a time clock, or there's an amount that gets less and less. So the one-time offer is made on what we call the sales page, the fourth area. And then it goes on, because once they've decided to take advantage of your one-time offer, they now are being thrown in what we call an upsell or downsell ladder. An upsell or downsell page ladder is an opportunity to increase your revenue or to have people stay when they decide to go away after they've seen the one-time offer. It is possible that after having seen the one-time offer, people still say no and they go away. They want to leave your website, or they want to leave your store, or they say, okay, not yet. I've seen what I needed to see, and I decided not yet to buy your stuff or to take your services. Then they are being brought into a downsell area, and the downsell area, the downsell ladder, literally says, okay, instead of 27, I'll give it for $10, or instead of $10, $5, or instead of $5, how about using it for free for three months? Or there are even people that say, we'll give you money if you try it, or if you become a member, or if you bring other people on. So the downsell ladder is really about letting people to stay in your loop, stay in your sales funnel. And obviously it's also an upsell ladder opportunity, because once they've committed to the one-time offer sales page and they're ready to pay the $27 or whatever your offer tells them they can get it for, you can also say, okay, how about instead of buying the ebook for $27, purchasing the video tutorials, the video tutorial mini-series for $97. It's a normal value of $300. And now you can get it for 97. So the upsell ladder brings them really all the way up until you literally sell them a resale license, or sell them a house with the car, or you can make that as wild as you want. The upsell ladder literally is there to increase your revenue and to grant people a better product, a better type of product, a better service to make their lives more comfortable. That's the upsell and downsell ladder. So again, feeders, squeeze, landing, sales. Now the up and downsell ladder. From the up and down sell letter, they obviously go to the page where they can pay. It's called the merchant account page. On the merchant account page, it's simply a matter of lining up everything that they purchased and giving them the specific ways to pay. Visa, Master, American Express, one-time payment. You can use PayPal, PowerPay, whatever. I do recommend PowerPay, mind you. But that's an inside story advantage. So the merchant account is all there to get the money. And once you've got the money, you bring them to a next step. And that's the final step of the sales psychology before they go into the next ladder, to the next sales funnel. And that's the thank you plus tell a friend area. So it's the thank you plus tell a friend area. And the thank you tell a friend area is literally a video in where you say, hey, look, thank you very much for purchasing. Fantastic. Now, how about getting another 2 kilos of Belgian chocolate if you tell 100 of your friends? So it's, first of all, from gratitude, telling them thank you very much. And second of all, again, this is Dutch. And second of all, you say, and this is Dutch as well. Huh, that's fun. So you say thank you and you say tell a friend. And you give them something for free. And that's free. And that's thank you. So that's all about building a relationship and making sure that your sales funnel becomes viral. Because once you've got the email addresses of other people from those customers or affiliates or members, you can obviously build your lists. And it's all about list building in order to put up more sales funnels and more sales funnels. And then they obviously are being thrown into the next sales funnel. So it's a loop. You know, they go in one sales funnel all the way to the 7 steps and go out to the next sales funnel, 1 through 7 again, etc., etc., and around and around and around and around. So that's all about sales psychology. It's a lot of information. I'm going to shoot all the individual videos as well of all the individual pages drawn out very big with the specifics, how to have them built by your page builders, or how to make them yourself, or have them done by us. That's possible as well. I want to wish you an awful lot of success. I hope this was very, very informative for you. You know the secrets about sales psychology now. Obviously, once you know the details and you're good in it, and you know exactly where you are in the sales process, you can then literally put several steps in one. So it's all about practicing, getting good in it, getting comfortable with it, getting rid of the ego flashes that you have, and make sure that, for example, in one video you can bring people all the way from feeder to thank you and tell a friend. I can do it, you can do it. In one video you can literally crank up their interest, portray them a better lifestyle, inform them about what you're doing, give them a one-time offer, have them purchase it, and purchase even more that they actually set out to purchase, and have them in your inner circle marketing group by telling other people about you. So in one video you can do all of it, and eventually you make videos like that by literally studying and practicing these 7 steps. And that makes life a lot easier, because you just shoot videos then and put a sales funnel in the back of it and a buy button, and you're done. That's it. Tweet to lead. Wishes you all the best. I'll see you later.